No, no, it's like while getting perfect, we also share, okay, there is one technique. As she mentioned, awareness is the key. If I don't know it is there, then I might not go in that direction. You said, okay, there is something there, then at least I'll have some idea, okay. If something strikes, okay, I should go this direction. So that will help. So everybody ready to move on?
Yes.
Cleanse.
See, these cleansing techniques and helpline techniques, these are very useful, and I also urge you to teach others. Help them know this. There are these beautiful techniques, and these are very, very, very useful. I will tell many stories around these techniques and how different lives changed. Okay, so the first technique, I'll go directly go to healing techniques, the self-healing techniques. The primary and the most important part is cleansing. When I say cleansing, what do you mean by cleansing? What are you cleansing?
The negative energy from your body.
Negative energy from your body. What is the nature of negative energy?
Illness, sadness, mm-hmm. stress,
depression,
negative emotions,
feeling bad. Guilt.
Making other people feel bad.
Guilt. Jealousy. Then what? Comparison, expectations. Mm-hmm. Anger. Mm-hmm. Anger. Mm-hmm. Then?
Hurt.
Right? So, I wanted to do a quick technique, a small technique. So, just is to make you feel better for at this moment, energized now, before we go into all these techniques. Turn to the right person, the person next to you, and say to him, "You are the best in the world." So, how did you feel it?
I feel awesome.
So, how many of you really meant what you said?
I meant it.
I gave her a reason also.
See, when the true feeling comes from your heart and with the purity you deliver those words, that will energize the person who listens to those words and the person who delivers those words. This is the positive effect. Okay? So now, the other technique you are going to do is turn to the right person and say, "I hate you."
No, we can just say, "I lied to you."
See how hard it is.
I just lied to you.
So you are mentioning about the direction, right?
Yeah, right or left.
Right person.
So whoever, because when you say hate, I hate, the moment you feel bad about it, even to say I hate.
Yeah.
But when I said you are the best person, can you say, everybody started saying. That is our nature. What is our true nature? Our true nature is the beautiful. the purity. Purity is our nature. And but what is happening? We are polluting that purity with various aspects of our life. And saying that I am full of negativity. So where is this negativity coming from? Remember one thing, negativity is not there outside. Negativity comes from within. Huh? I didn't have any negativity, I didn't do any harm to others. That's right. But you hold 11 million impressions of this, all your actions in your subconscious mind. 11 million. But in your conscious mind, you have only a couple of them. Right? But what about 11 million? Do you remember? You have been carrying all these impressions for several births. How to cleanse those 11 million impressions that are residing dormant within you, that is dictating your life? See, what is that? Out of 11 million, couple of them comes up in your conscious mind and you execute them. See, suppose I don't like X person. Whenever I see, I feel as if I am on fire, you know. I don't like to be with that person at all. Why does it happen? Tell me, can you tell me? Why does it happen? Because in my past, in my past life, that I hated that person a lot.
Karmic.
Those impressions I have been carrying from past birth into this life. Now, whenever I see that person, he starts abusing me, ill-treating me. Then I experience, what did I do? She's bad. And we start blaming that X person, she or he, whoever it is. Then, what is he doing? Tell me. What is that X person doing? He's paying back his debt. Am I right? He's paying back his debt so that you are out of that impression you have been carrying in your life. I'll give you an example. This thing happened, really happened. One person from Texas called me and he said, I'm not talking to my parents since 7 years. I said, what happened? I don't know, they hate me. They don't want to be with me. Said, okay. What do you want? I want my parents to talk to me. Then what should I do? Whenever I just try to talk to them or go near them, they start hating me and they just turn away. Then he felt very bad. Then I said, see, they have given you birth. They brought you onto this earth plane. This is not the way you have to behave with your parents. You must keep on doing, like try to talk to them, and keep on sending love energy to them all the time. So can you, is there any technique that I can, that make me feel good about them and I can start talking to them? I said, do meditation. So do with me for 20 minutes, then we shall see what will happen. Then he did meditation for 20 minutes. And in 20 minutes, couple of things happened. The first thing happened is he felt calmness and his Ishta Devata, Shiva, he had the glimpse of that Shiva's energy experience. So, second thing what happened was, I went into his past life. Unknowingly, that's how happened, I don't know. And I saw he was ill-treating his parents like anything. He's not providing food, like beating them. They were doing all kinds of things. Then I realized why they were hating him now at that time. And after the meditation, 20 minutes meditation, he said, I asked him, how did you feel? I said, I felt great because I had the glimpse of energy. And I told him, this is the vision I got. This is what happened in your past life that is causing your this experience. The moment you know the past, that means you are done with that karma. That karma is annihilated. The moment you get the glimpse. As soon as I told him that experience, shared that experience with him, I told him, from this moment, your karma is gone. Then you should be good with your parents now. And they should feel good about you too. And then I told him, then gone, done. After 3 months, I got a phone call from him again. And he said, something miracle happened. What happened? I went to India and I tried to meet my parents. This time they received me so well, our bond increased. Now I took them for Tirthayatra, Ujjain, Mahakaleshwar, like he took them to all temples. And then their bondage has increased and now they are happy and everything turned 360 degrees. Then he said, I thought these are all stories, but now when I experience personally, I feel very, very good. Now, thanks for everything. I said, don't thank me. This is the divine that helped you. I am an instrument here. So thank him and do meditation. Don't forget that which helped you in this journey. So what happened here? In this story, what we learnt is, whatever we give in the past, we pay back for that. So we have to release that debt. So the cleansing which I am talking about is cleansing those 11 million impressions we unknowingly carry within us. So what happens? A person is treating me, ill-treating me, then I say, I apply these techniques, what will happen? The impression I am carrying by which he is ill-treating me, that connection is gone. Then you will have a beautiful person before you. Your relationship improves, everything improves, the health improves.
Impression in a sense, what is the impression?
Karmic impression, the karmic memory, karmic impression.
Impression of the person ill-treating you or?
Yeah, impression ill-treating you. Because of that only, because you hold the grudge against that person. You carry that for many births.
So even he also has that.
Yeah, he also has, yes.
That,
so when you cleanse from your side, from his side also will be cleansed. That's what happened to him.
You are
right?
Only closing the karmic account. You are from our side. But that
no, even from that side also will be closed. That is the power of cleansing.
Both sides.
Both sides. Because that's what happened to him, right? When he does meditation and when this past experience happened, what happened? Even they forgot about that. Everything gone, right?
So it's the same parents? Like
same even in this birth, they were the same parents.
Same parents.
Same parents.
Previous.
Previous. So when he did the cleansing happened on their side too. The karmic link is totally...
So everyone may not be competent enough to know the past.
Yeah, that is because you know the past, right? That is the reason these cleansing tools came into existence.
So without knowing or identifying, just cleanse it.
Then cleanse it. So that it will cleanse whatever the impressions we have been carrying for the past several lives. We are cutting off. So that better relationship, better health, everything, the best things will come into our life. This is the purpose of cleansing. That is the cleansing. When I say cleansing, this is what I mean, the cleansing. The first tool is, I don't know how you remember, because...
We want to write
this is
a video, I think.
Papers,
maybe.
Papers and pens.
This will, I tell you, and please pay very good attention to this. Suppose I have some health issue, okay?
Can I bring my phone and record it at least?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah,
this one for Reno. for everybody and stuff, you know. Only.
Yeah, yeah, we'll upload the video.
Only.
You want to write?
Okay. Record.
No, I'm recording.
I'm also recording it here.
recording the video, we'll upload it.
Okay.
Yeah, you can write.
Can you turn that off and use it whenever needed?
This one? Oh, sure.
You can put it
on the
distraction. Oh, yeah, yeah, sure. Okay.
Okay, please listen to this carefully. Either it is a disease or relationship problem or energy issue or anything, any issue. Okay? So this technique will be helpful in any situation. Okay, so thing is, suppose some person is hating me, ill-treating me all the time, then this is what I tell to myself as a cleansing tool. What is going on in me? Okay, what is going on in me? That person is behaving with me so and so way. Okay, what is going on in me? That person is behaving with me or ill treating me. Let all these unwanted energies, vibrations, memories, and blocks. Let all these unwanted energies, vibrations, memories, and blocks be transmuted to pure light, and it is done. Transmuted to pure light, and it is done. If it is a health issue, suppose I am suffering from so and so health issue, knee pain, suppose. What is going on in me that I am experiencing intense knee pain? Let all these unwanted energies, vibrations, memories, and blocks be transmuted into pure light, and it is done. The moment you start, why I am saying this? Maybe some karma that I brought in from previous birth or previous action that is causing me this pain. Okay? So what I am doing here, I am saying this so that the impression, the karma related to this pain is cut off. And my pain is gone. Understood? This is very important. I use the word transmute. What do you mean by transmute? Change from one form to other. Why did I say that? Because if I say that, oh God, please remove this pain, please remove this pain, please remove this pain, what will happen? This pain will go and sit in the universe.
It will go to somebody else.
It will go to somebody else. That is called negative energy. So that there are three types of karmas, you know, results. Adi, Ajhatmika, Adi Bhautika, and then Adi Daivika. What do you mean by this?
Adhyatmika is something related to body, Adi Bhautika is something related to the universe, Adi Daivika is something related to God.
Related to God. Okay.
Adi,
so
Adi Bhautika is something that actually comes from external being.
Okay. So Adhyatmika means there are six beautiful qualities in us. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya. There are six beautiful qualities. So all the impressions we carry in this life, because of these six qualities, okay, form adhyatmika tapam. These are called tritapa. Okay? So the first thing, whatever, because of desire, anger, or all these we accumulate karma. We accumulate karma knowingly. Right? Knowingly we accumulate. This karma is called tritapa. This is tapam. Tapam means the fire energy, that energy that we carry. Everything is in the form of energy. So this adhyatmika tapa, karma, energy. This is one type of negative energy. Second type of negative energy is adi bhautika. Okay? Somebody else creates this karma for me. Right? Unknowingly you will come across and you will talk all nonsense and I will feel bad and come out. This is called adi bhautika. Or somebody plans something, I'll be going onto the road and he comes behind and hit the car. That is a karma on me. Then I have to call the cop and everything. I have to go through this process. This is called adi bhautikata. It's a kind of negative energy I attract into my life. Third thing is adi daivika. Adi daivika means all these droughts and floods, everything which are beyond your imagination or anything. Control. So this is adi daivika. These are all negative energies, is a result of our negative energy only. Even though there were three names given, but it's out of all our negative energies. So we should, the most dangerous is adi ajatmika. Ajatmika. That is 90% of our negative energies are derived from those actions. 9% is adi bhautika. 1% is adi daivika. So where should we work? Cleansing? Adhyatmika. Mind and body. So this cleansing. The first technique I use is transmutation. That's the reason. Don't say, God, please remove pain. All my difficulties, don't say please remove. You use the word transmute. Please transmute all these unwanted energies. Please, to pure light.
What is the Indian word for that? Transmute. What is the Indian Sanskrit?
Paravartana. So, complete change. Transformation. Okay? And another thing, remember, we don't know how to pray. Please, trust me. We don't know how to pray. We pray God, somebody prayed like this, oh God, please remove my pain from my knee. Remove my pain. And what it was, he removed it. Then after 1 month, he again went to God and said, God, you removed pain but not swelling. There was a swelling. He didn't remove the swelling, but he removed the pain. Why did it happen? Because you don't know what to ask for. You think I am intelligent fellow on this earth plane. But he is more intelligent than me. So the way you have to ask, the way you do the prayer is very important too. What should you ask? Oh God, grant me whatever you think best for me. That is what you needed. Don't ask all these things. He knows everything. But what you need, grant me whatever you think best for me. Only thy will be done. When you say that, then he will start entering into our life. He takes care of, takes control of your life. That's it. Then when our logical mind comes into picture, everything collapses. Remember this. I prayed, but I don't know. What does it mean? They say, you know, what?
You full control.
Full control to him. You are not, there is no total surrender. The moment you say, ah, done. Then what? కానీ ఎందుకైనా మంచిది. వెన్ యు సే బట్ యువర్ గాడ్ యు ఫినిష్డ్
అన్కండిషన్.
దేర్ ఇస్ అ జోక్ విచ్ హాస్ బీన్ సర్క్యులేటెడ్ దీస్ డేస్. సంబడి ఆస్క్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ కంప్లీట్ అండ్ ఫినిష్డ్. హీ సెడ్ if you marry a right woman you are complete, if you marry a wrong woman you are finished.
Other way around too.
Yeah, this is with men too. So this is the first thing. And so before going to anything, after this is one kind of cleansing technique. It can be applied to anything, is the disease or relationship, anything. The second is very very important. Wherever you go, wherever you go, before going to that place, you must chant these four words, thinking of that house, that place. Or suppose I want to sit here, I say to this, I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. Okay, if you say it loud, people think you are mad fellow. Because that is what it is, the energy that it carries, this this one is very powerful. That is the reason I suggest that, you know, whenever you sit for prayer or japa or jhana, whatever, there is one place, right, you sit and pray. Don't never ever ask other to sit on the same place. That should be reserved for your own vibrations, for your own task. Don't ask anybody to sit on your, don't share with anybody.
You're talking about the asana?
Pita. That is only for you. Remember this. No, no children can come, wife can come. No. In terms of spirituality, wife is wife, husband is husband.
What about the plate that you consume your food in? Should be like that too?
No.
That is fine, but you can cleanse it. But whatever you do, you have to cleanse it.
Okay.
Either the plate or seat or whatever it is, you have to cleanse it. Remember this. But I strongly advise, when you do the spiritual sadhana, please follow these instructions. Don't share this with anybody. And before using any chair or place or anything, you please cleanse that place. You say, I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. Who am I saying this?
The energy inside that.
Energy. That energy that is causing that. We don't know what relationship it is with that. Okay? So the moment you say that, whatever the impressions I carry, that I was dragged to this, move away. Cleanse. So the basic thing that happens with this is 100% clarity. The thought pattern happens. The clarity in thought, because sometimes we don't know the decision. I tell you what happened in my personal experience. Why I am advocating all these techniques to you? Why should I do? Because I experienced personally. In many many situations, I really got solutions out of this. That is the reason I am advocating. My father was in coma. In Delhi, Apollo Hospital, he had a cancer. Then we live in Hyderabad. I had to move my father from Delhi to Hyderabad, bring home. He is in coma. He is in fourth stage cancer. The time he was in fourth stage cancer. Then doctor said, if you remove oxygen, he was on oxygen, if you remove him and move, by the time you carry him to that wherever that place is, he will die for sure. They scared me, scared my family members. Then I said, I never get scared because I trust in the divine power. I said, okay. I listened to them. I came and sat and cleansed. I did this. Literally, I did this. I love you. I am sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. And
for which one you did? Towards the
like
cancer?
Whether to take him or move him or not. What is going on in me that I am experiencing all these situations? There is resistance from all people, like doctors and everybody. And I sat. The moment I completed that, my inner voice told me, move him. That's it. I didn't listen to even doctors, nobody. You know what happened after that? The moment I decided, I told them, I'm moving him. And they were surprised. Everybody was surprised why he decided to move in spite of our warnings. Then suddenly, I don't know, from nowhere, one doctor came and said, I know how to move him. I will go with him. And he came to Hyderabad, and that the coma patient was moved to Hyderabad without any issues. So every step, when you cleanse that, things will, you will see the wonders in your life. And because you are negating negative energy, negating negative energy, that means you are inviting all positive energy in your life. So lot of decisions I took like that.
So when you're doing the cleansing here, what was the cleansing for? I got confused right there, because you're not cleansing an object, you're not cleansing a place. In your example,
yeah,
you're trying to decide whether to move your father from Delhi to Hyderabad,
mm-hmm,
but you have to make a decision. So how did this cleansing process help you to make the decision? And what were you cleansing? Were you cleansing your mind?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. See, this is your... This is very important. Understand, this is very important thing. You have a conscious mind. Conscious mind.
Mm-hmm.
You have a subconscious mind. Okay? And then, beyond this, there is one more conscious. What is that? Super conscious. Right? There is a super conscious. And below this, there's one more conscious. What is that? Unconscious. Okay? So, what is happening here? I carry 11 million impressions here. Am I right? How many?
11 million.
11 million impressions. So, when I say, so suppose if I am experiencing the pain, the memory of this impression causing me this pain, what is that? Memory, which I don't remember that karma, right? That is a memory.
Yes.
So the memory of that pain in my subconscious mind causing me this pain. So what I am cleansing here?
Removing the memory, cleansing the memory.
I am cleansing that memory. The moment, in order to do that, what I do is, when I say, I love you, I am sorry, I am putting a request to the super conscious. Hey, I love you, I am sorry, oh divine, I don't know, I don't remember my past memory, I don't know what to do with it, I don't even remember the things I have done few days ago. How can I remember past life things? I don't know. I am sorry. Please forgive me for that. But I love you. You have a solution for me. So then he says, oh, he is doing something for me. Then he says, okay. He works through this and says that subconscious mind, okay, please erase this instruction. Please erase this memory. when this memory is erased, you are free from pain. So this is how, that means the moment you say I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you, you are making a petition to superconscious mind. The superconscious mind says, superconscious says, okay, now I'll make sure that whatever the pattern, the memory you are carrying in your subconscious mind, out of this 11 million, one is stuck. Then you are cleansed. That memory is gone. In our Sanskrit terms, the subconscious pool is called Sanchita. Sanchita karma. So we accumulated knowingly or unknowingly.
So that we don't know.
That we don't know. But still we are accumulating. Now 11 million plus.
Yes.
No, but in this, your father's case, you are only submitting to the superconscious, you are not erasing it.
Then whatever is the karma that is forming, coming as a resistance for me in moving my father, that memory is cleansed.
Yes, okay. It makes sense.
So the resistance is gone. What did they say? If you move your father to Hyderabad, he will die. So normal feeling is, I should not move, right? That is the impediment, that is a process impediment. Some karma is causing that all this grief or mental pain and everything, right? Some karma, some impression. So what they did was, yeah, they removed that karma memory that caused that mental pain in me.
Mm-hmm.
Then clarity came.
So you are not able to make a decision because of fear and confusion.
Fear and confusion.
So the fear and confusion is taken away and then you make a decision.
The clarity came.
So are you
came.
Saying that that's the point. Every minute of life that we live is
related
to anything that we are thinking, doing, or any action.
Yes,
that is
related
to
one of
the
memories.
Yeah. Past impression,
past
yes.
Impression.
You are
past.
Uh-huh. The superconscious means the divine.
Divine. Yes. Superconscious. And one more thing you must remember is, when I say this, suppose you are X, the other person is Y. Okay? Remember always, this is important thing. X is perfect, always. Y is also perfect. What is the imperfection? The memory link between you and that person is imperfect. That's it. That person is good, perfect, and you are perfect. The memory link between you and that person is wrong. So what you are doing? You are erasing. Then relationship grows. So where is the blame game here?
Memory.
There is no memory is the blame. You should blame the memory, not the person. So who is responsible for to clear that memory?
We are.
So
there
we are 100%.
We are in this case, another person is also responsible, right?
No, you can cleanse and he will be cleansed automatically.
Yeah. So when you cleanse this memory, both are perfect. Where is the other person memory?
So anybody can do the memory, either
okay.
They can do it or...
See, what are miracles?
So they can do it.
So it can be deleted.
He already shifted it to the other side.
No, you know, what are miracles? What are miracles? Oh, you say, oh, Lord, I got the lottery. What is this? What? Somebody cleansed your karma. Somebody cleansed our karma, that's the reason you got the lottery. So you got health. 1 month ago, somebody was diagnosed with tumor. After 1 month, tumor is gone from his system. Who did that? Somebody cleansed his karma. That is the miracle.
Knowingly or unknowingly?
Knowingly or unknowingly. That is the reason I am telling you. The moment you have a positive thought at this moment, you are saving some person crossing the road. That's what I was referring at the beginning of the session. So, increase the consciousness, increase the positive energy, that would impact the whole world, whole universe.
Mm-hmm.
It is not only the human kingdom, it is a plant kingdom, animal kingdom, unconscious, a mineral kingdom, every mineral.
So then every fresh account that you are starting will be...
Yes. Yes.
Because there is always a new accounts are also starting getting
starting, exactly. And you are bringing the new consciousness.
Problem is that vibe may or may not be a bad person. We just think it is a bad person. And we are afraid, we are angry,
exactly.
It's a perception.
Because of the, you are defined by memory. You are not pure. I mean pure, your memory is not pure, not you. You are perfect. The problem is with memory. Why I don't get A plus grades? Because of
memory.
So what will happen is, you put it on memory, don't just put it on memory and try to cleanse it so that next time you will get A plus grade.
Some
memory caused you not to get A plus grade, right? When you remove that memory, what will happen? You get A plus grade.
So you must do this 11 million times to cleanse all.
Yeah, that is the secret. You need not do 11 million times. That is the beauty about it. When you keep on doing this, the superconscious divinity says, I am happy with your effort. I will cleanse at one moment.
Yeah.
11 million gone. Now you are happy person, go.
Please repeat again. Please repeat.
No. What she said was, do I need to cleanse 11 million times? Because 11 million impressions. Right? So what I said was, no need to do that. If you keep on cleansing, what happens is at one point of time, superconscious thinks, I'm happy with him. This is called what Krishna says, Jnanagni Dagdha Karmanam. The moment of clarity, the sparkness, the spark happens. The moment you get that spark, 11 million becomes zero.
Sometimes, you know, when you in IT program, the dot is missing, so you get like 1,000 errors.
Yes, exactly.
Put it down with this
one. That's it. So, in one moment, so that is the reason cleansing is very powerful thing. So, I want everybody to practice this. So, next thing which I am going to answers her question. Because next technique which I am going to teach cleanses many thousands of karmas in one breath. So I'll teach you this. Do it wherever you go. First do it. Okay? So I'm going to teach that. Everybody must do this. Those who can't hold a lot, what they can do is, as per their capacity, they do it. Okay? This is 7 times breathing. You need to do this 7 times. Okay? What you do is, 7 count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Did you get it? 7. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold. Then breathe out 7 times. 7. Then hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale 7 count. Hold 7 count. Exhale 7 count. Hold 7 count. How many times? 21. So 28. 4 times 7. 7 times 28. You have to do this cycle for 7 times. So 7 times 28, how much? What? 7 times 21, 28. See, they karma cleansed. See, you have to do more breathing. Okay? So 7 times 7.
But usually exhale, they say count long or something like that.
This is cleansing techniques.
Okay.
All equal. 7 inhaling, hold seven, exhale seven, hold seven.
All these seven has to be equal, equal intervals.
Equal intervals.
So whatever interval you choose.
You choose. Suppose if I say, I am very lazy person. What I do is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's it. But what I do is, at least give some time, say, breathe in. If you can't hold for 7 counts, hold for few counts. Fast. Count fast while holding. But do it 7 times, 20, I mean 4 times 7, that's 28 times 7. Those many times. In one sequence. Suppose if the problem is severe, do it 3 times a day. Suppose my pain is very severe, I want to cleanse that other person. Is whenever I see that person, he starts blaming me, hurting me, hating me, like that. What you do is, sit, don't blame that person. That person is perfect. Remember, what is the problem? Memory is problem. Nobody is, everybody in this whole universe is perfect. Remember that. Don't blame those persons. What you should blame is memory. So, what as soon as some person is troubling you, suppose boss is troubling me, I say sit down there itself in the workplace. Breathe in, breathe out. Right? That's it.
If he asks, tell him I'm cleansing your.
You need not.
So you need to think about the person and then.
There is no sleeping, this is all fast.
But
seven, at least that effect, to feel the experience, the effect, that is the count.
As long as you know this person is doing it, we can at least cleanse him. There is lot of things happening, you get lot of unidentified or unknown negative.
That's the reason, if you keep on doing it, everything will go away. Automatically they will go away. You will see that, you know, maybe you had a animosity with somebody else in this world. Suddenly he will call you and say, I miss you so much, I love you so much, when are we meeting? This happened in Texas, Dallas. She calls me brother. She called me one day and said, my friend and I had some argument. Then she stopped talking to me. What should I do? She said, cleanse. I said, your friend is perfect. Just keep cleansing, doing cleansing. Then she said, okay. Then put down the phone. Then after 7 days, she called me. Your cleansing worked. What happened? She called me. She came to my home and said, sorry for this argument. And we both were happy and we started talking. That's a good thing. So keep on cleansing. Don't stop it there. I said, see, because we don't know, as you said, there are unknown things, 11 million things in our system. We don't know all of them. So we're just doing that.
What I'm saying is, when you know, there are some people, they will be, let's say, for example, they'll be acting as our very good bosom friends,
mm-hmm.
but they may be holding some,
definitely,
some negative thoughts.
Even that will be removed.
Don't know, they don't express it or they don't show it outwardly. So unless you know that this is a person who's sending you the negative energy.
Yeah, you need not know. Because how can you know 11 million impressions?
So you just...
You need not know.
Just think of cleansing and do cleansing.
Yeah, just do cleansing. Then
he or she,
clarity will come, everything will happen. Maybe that boss will be removed from that system itself. it really happened.
It cleanses the UFOs.
Yeah. Because one lady I met in Washington DC, she had a fight with her manager. And every time she sees her, he wants to trouble her, right? Some words or whatever this. Then she got fed up with this. Then she learned, she came for the workshop, for this cleansing workshop. She learned techniques and started doing this every day. Then one day they got a circulation saying that organizational announcement. He was moved to different office.
Only he was doing the same cleansing. What if he was doing the same cleansing?
When they are very impure, they don't even get to this technique session. So that idea won't come. So we are fortunate to know these techniques at this time. So now we are cleansing this house, this place, for the opportunity given. So we want to do something for bridge. So everybody, we do 7 times. Okay. And the way you do is, there, whoever sits on the chair, what they do is, they can do like this. Like that. Or if you have difficulty even putting like this, you can sit like this. Jnana Mudra. This is called Jnana Mudra. You can sit like this. Okay. And keep doing 7 times. According to your capacity. If you can't hold 7 counts, do it fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then, so whatever your capacity holds. You know? So let's
so
do
inhale
it.
Inhale for 7. Keep for 7.
Yeah. Again, inhale for 7. Hold for 7. Exhale for 7. Hold for 7. Okay. Any doubts? 7 times you have to do. Till that time, don't open your eyes. Just focus on your breathing. Just relax. Let it take 4 minutes or 5 minutes. Just do it, okay? Close your eyes and keep doing. lot of negative energy will be gone from you.
I have a question. So while doing this, were we supposed to feel relaxed? I felt a lot of pressure inside, like while doing.
Yes, it will come.
Was that correct?
Yeah. Because you are holding it, right? Then it will relax after. After that, take deep breath and because you are holding. And that too eight. So the pressure will come. That's fine. So and whenever now you know, wherever you go, first you reasonable technique is I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. Suppose the camera is there, computer is there, mouse, everything. What you said, first you say, I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. Then you start using it. So second thing is if is the problem is severe, we want clarity in more in urgent way, then you do it more, like 3 times a day. Wherever you
cycles
whenever,
of 7 into 28.
Many times. See, as many times as you do, more clarity will come.
So you're saying like, you know, if we do like 8 times instead of 7, it doesn't have to be 8 instead of 7.
No, only 7. Only 7.
So it's more like, you know, it's 7, 7, 7, 7, 7.
It's all
in 7.
All this 7. Just make it a practice. Just do 7, 7, 7, 7.
And 7 times.
7 times.
Only 7 times.
Only 7 times. There is a beautiful book, if you want to buy or order or in the public library, there is a book called Zero Limits. Zero Limits, which deals with this process.
Who is the author?
Zero Limits.
Joe
Vitale. J-O-E. Joe V-I-T-A-L-E.
So he speaks about cleansing?
Cleansing. He speaks about real experiences of cleansing and everything. There's a master called Dr. Hewlett. From him, I learnt all these techniques. That Hewlett, when he learnt this technique, he's a psychiatrist by profession. What happened was, he got a request from all those prisoners,
in Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh or something.
In Hawaii, there's a prison where all the, you know, the people who killed, who committed severe crimes, they were placed in that prison. So they said, and they used to behave in a weird manner. And they used to kill persons, whoever goes, nurses and doctors, whoever go to them, they used to do a lot of things for them. Then they said, Dr. Hewlett, this is what we are facing here in this prison. I said, okay, you got all those names. He didn't visit those persons at all. He started doing cleansing. Within a 1 year, the prison became empty. Everybody became all right and they were sent home. So he cleansed on them. When he cleansed on them, what happened? All the karmic patterns or the impressions they were there that has been carried, they were all gone.
It sounds like voodoo to me.
But when he's doing that, see that. That is lot of negative energy. Right?
Correct.
So when he is cleansing it, is he also taking lot of negative energy? He has to be so strong in the positive.
Transmute.
Yeah, but
yeah, he vibrates at a lot of higher level.
How do you get to the level?
Yes.
We have to practice to get to that level.
Oh yes, yeah. He has done that for 20 years.
So
to get to that level.
The same thing?
Same thing, breathing, yeah. 7 breathings and I love you, I am sorry, please forgive me, thank you. And there are little, suppose strawberries improves relationships. So vanilla ice cream, don't eat much. It's good for cleansing. Like there are some certain tools which are also helpful.
So he did for them.
He did for them. And basically, he cleansed his karma. See, when the request came to him, that means he has some bonding with them. He cleansed that bonding.
Oh, okay.
Understood.
Yeah.
That I'll remove that karmic link.
So it could be a divine order.
Divine.
Coming
to
go and clean that.
So I actually came across a book called Many Masters, Many Lives by Brian and Lise.
I read that.
Yeah.
What is that?
So it's basically said like, you know,
many masters, many lives.
Mm.
Yeah.
So he's a psychiatrist, so he was thinking about past life regression therapy and all of those things. So in that, you know, finally when that lady who he is basically working on, when she thinks about all her past lives, she has taken, like, you know, in that book she has had like 88 past lives that she could remember.
She got cleansed.
Yeah. And after that she basically came out of all the fears that she had, all the, you know, fights that she was having around people around her. But one thing is, like, you know, even in Bhagavad Gita Krishna says, like, you know, everyone around you, you are there by time, place and circumstance. Unless you get all of those million factors right, you will not be born. So in the same manner, like in that book, whoever she actually comes across around her, she is actually seeing all of them in her present life.
Correct. Yes, exactly.
Yeah. She
has, because in different roles,
everyone in some way or the other.
Because unless the karmic link is broken, you have to visit him again and again and again to pay back. So cleansing helps to remove that link. That's it. You are done.
These two techniques that you mentioned to us today, and I get it on your website. I know I went to your blog and I read your blog also.
Mm-hmm.
Is it available? Because I know by the time we get the video, it may be like 3 days from now, 4 days from now. And we want to go home and practice this at home. And I do not have that good of a memory, so.
I can give you, send you my email.
Oh,
give
okay.
me, yeah.
Thank you.
With the instructions. That's not a problem.
You have videos on your website?
Not yet, I'm still in the development. Yeah. It will come.
So, could you put a name?
Will
put
that will be
really helpful. Yeah,
maybe.
Definitely.
Well, it has nice.
And
so you have a.
There's one experience.
You have a guru in India that you started with, or is this?
See, I met many gurus. So, in 30 years, I've seen many gurus, learned many things with them. Even I learnt this technique directly from Hewlett, Dr. Hewlett. So, I met many masters. I have seen brainwaves, I have seen all the past life regressioners. I met them. I did lot of things. One of the experiences, like when it came to me, like when you mentioned this past life regression, one girl was suffering from severe asthma attack. So she went to the past life regression therapy and she said, why am I suffering with this severe attack at the young age? I said, okay, we'll regress you. Then they took her to the past life. You know what happened? At the time of her death, she was drowned into a river, and because of lack of breath she died. So next birth she primary complex of asthma. So when she experienced, she relived that experience, from that moment she is out of asthma.
My daughter has asthma, but she didn't have till her second birth. She developed it when after her second birth. So
that
same thing with my daughter, second birthday.
Yeah, so that means
yeah.
You see that karma, whenever it enters, that impression comes, you have to experience that. But you can reverse it at this time.
How?
You start cleansing.
You have to
cleanse. These breathing techniques, when you apply, asthma can be reversed. Because when you do these breathing, what happens is it works on your karma, that memory that is causing this asthma. When you remove the memory, asthma is gone. Right? This is some karma caused this, some memory caused this disease. Am I right? What are you trying to do with these techniques? you are removing this memory. What happened to Asma? This works, I tell you. This is not a mere story.
Mm-hmm.
This is a factual. I experience. I tell you this. I experience it. My wife does it every time. Even she does it for parking lot. As soon as she enters the mall, she says, I love you, I am sir, please forgive me, thank you. Then she finds the parking spot.
Can you stay here for holidays?
No, not harmful. Like you saying asthma or anything, it will be gone with cleansing and all.
Yeah.
Still,
I
cannot connect to that.
Because you are working on the memory.
It's a cleansing process.
No, but if it's only memory, it's like.
See, that bacteria comes when you have that memory, then only bacteria
comes.
As long as that memory is there, bacteria will be there. When the memory is cleansed, bacteria is gone.
Basically, you are getting unattached and you are freeing yourself from the emotions.
I'll tell you one more story.
Much, right?
Okay, for you to confirm this, I'll give you another fact happened. A woman called me from Pittsburgh. Her grandson was suffering from colon problem.
Colic.
Crohn's.
Because it happens to one person in. Colitis, disease was very harsh, and he was in hospital for many years, like the suffering. And she called me, can you help me with him? Because I can't bear, he's about 10 or 12 years old. I can't bear his pain, I can't see him suffering. And I said, the only cleansing tools I have is all this. I told her, like, keep doing this at the hospital, go and sit with him. Go on doing this all the time. Then she was doing, and I was doing my prayers. Then one day it so happened that I had the divine vision of the Shirdi Sai Baba came in and cleansing him. Then I called her and said, I got the vision and he will be alright. As a grandmother, having seen his pain, he didn't trust my words. She said, okay, how can that happen? It's just, I said, this is my vision. This is reality. This is not, you know, I was dreaming. This is happened in my meditation. This happened. That's it. I trust this. Even if you don't trust, I trust this. This is what happens. He will be all right. Then after 3 months, he called me. He came home and he's doing good. He's happy. Kid. So, what is the answer for this? So, it is the belief with which we faith. So that works miracles, the cleansing. When you say this is Krishna and Arjuna, right? Do you think Arjuna could able to fight the war without Krishna? No. What happened exactly? Krishna's energy, Arjuna's effort, and Arjuna's faith in Krishna's energy. Three things work together. Understood? Krishna's energy, Arjuna's effort, and Arjuna's faith in the energy of Krishna that work miracles. So in the same way, when we do with this sincerity and commitment, you are cleansing. One lady came to the Hulan workshop, this then she said, I think his her grandson, her grandson was suffering from what is that? ADHD. And also like he was behaving weirdly. And she said, she came to Hewlett and asked her, like, can he be cured? Said, yes, of course, 100%. I said. Then she went back and she stopped it. Doing. 1 month, no result. 2 months, no result. 1 year, no result. I think this technique is not good for me.
Well, at least she tried for 1 year.
1 year. Then he said, don't give up. Clean. Because the karmic memory is so strong, it needs more cleansing. Don't give up. It works. Trust me. Then he pushed her back. Then she started doing. Like that she did